Hello friends, I'm Naval Yemul, working as an assistant professor in Mechanical Engineering Department, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In this video, we are going to see the programs on C++ Part 3. Learning outcome: at the end of this session, students will be able to understand basic programs of C++. Content of the video is programs on C++. The first program, C++ program to separate individual digits from an integer and find sum of the digits. So separating the individual digits from an integer, we have seen on the last video, that is programs on C++ part 2. Please go through it. Here we are seeing the same program and finding the sum of the digits. We are using two header files, then int main. We are taking five variables now. First is number a, comma b, comma c, d, and sum. So there are six variables in total, including sum. So c out, enter any three digit number. That three digit number is stored in number. A equal to number modulus of 10 or percent symbol. So whenever we are using a percent symbol, we get a remainder, that is 3. So b equal, we are taking six variables: number, a comma b comma c comma d, and sum. Enter any three digit number. That three digit number is stored in number. A equal to number percent or sim modulus of 10. Whenever we are using percent symbol, that means we get a remainder. Suppose a user enters three digit number as 123 modulus of 10, gives the remainder, that is 3. We are taking second variable b is equal to number divided by 10. So this is normal division, that is 123 divided by 10. We get only a quotient, that is 12. We are taking third variable. Now the value of b is 12. So b mod of 10, that is 12 percent 10. We get again remainder as 2. We are using fourth variable, that is b divided by 10. If we divide 12 by 10, we get a quotient as 1. So now c out, number, the number will be entered or number will be displayed. So the program is continuing in the next slide. So c out, a is called, c is called, and d is called. And this A, C, and D are again summed. So the next equation is sum equal to A plus C plus D. So the sum of the three digits are, we are calling sum. So the output for the program will be enter any three digit number. Suppose if the user enters 1, 2, 3, A value will be equal to 3, C value will be equal to 2, D value will be equal to 1. And the sum of all these three digits will be 3 plus 2 plus 1, that comes to 6. So we'll see the next simple program of conversion. C++ program to convert centimeter into meter and kilometer. So taking the header file, int main, we are taking data type as float, three variables, km, that is kilometer, meter, and cent, that refers to centimeter. See out, convert centimeter into meter and kilometer. See out, input the distance in centimeter, and whatever the user enters stored in the variable cent. Then the logic here is, or the formula here is, meter will be equal to centimeter divided by 100. and kilometer is equal to centimeter divided by 10 raised to 6. See out the distance in meter is, we are calling meter. See out the distance in kilometer is, we are calling km. Return 0, finishing the problem. So the output for the previous program will be like convert centimeter into meter and kilometer will be the first statement. Input the distance in centimeter. If we enter 25,000, the distance in meter will be 2500 and the distance in kilometers will be 2.5. C++ program to convert temperature in Kelvin to Celsius. So pause the video for a few seconds, think on this program and try to recall the program. Okay, so C++ program to convert temperature in Kelvin to Celsius. So we are using two header files and two variables. We are using data type as float, Kelvin, variable is KEL, and Celsius, variable is CEL. So convert temperature in Kelvin to Celsius. Input the temperature in Kelvin, C in Kelvin. So the formula will be CEL, that is Celsius, is equal to Kelvin minus 273.15. So this is the formula. The temperature in Kelvin, we are calling Kelvin here, and the temperature in Celsius, we are calling CEL, the variable. So the output for the program will be convert temperature in Kelvin to Celsius. Input the temperature in Kelvin. Suppose the user enters 300 as a temperature in Kelvin will be 300 and the temperature in Celsius will be 26.85, that is 300 minus 273.15. So we'll see the next program, that is to convert kilometers per hour to miles per hour. So we are taking two header files, then int main, we are taking a data type float kmph and miph, that is mile per hour. So see out convert kilometers per hour to miles per hour. See out input the distance in kilometers. Whatever the user enters in kilometers, that is stored in kmph, and the formula for converting kilometer to mile per hour is mile per hour is equal to kilometer per hour into 0.6213712. See out the kilometer per hour means kmph, that will give you miph. So the output for the program will be converting kilometer per hour to miles per hour. Input the distance in kilometer. Suppose if the user enters 25, the 25 kilometer per hour means 15.5343 miles per hour. So we'll see the last program, that is C++ program to find the third angle of a triangle. We are using two header files, int main, float angle 1, angle 2, angle 3. See out find the third angle of a triangle. Input the first angle of the triangle, see in angle 1. See out input the second angle of the triangle, we are stored in angle 2. The third angle is calculated as 180 minus sum of the first two angles. So the third angle will be 180 minus angle 1 plus angle 2. So the third angle of the triangle is angle 3. So the output will be Find the third angle of a triangle. Input the first angle of the triangle. Suppose the user enters 30. Third statement will be input the second angle of the triangle, 60. The third angle of the triangle is calculated as 180 minus 30 plus 60. That comes to 180 minus 90 will be equal to 90. So these are the references. Thank you.